ask people to get in here.
Welcome to Houston Grand Opera's 35th annual Eleanor McCollum competition, the Concert of Arias. I am Nicole Houston, and I am here live in Houston at the Wortham Center. It is so great to have the Concert of Arias here today. I was the third place winner, as well as audience choice. Now, I have been with HGO since the beginning of my professional career. I started doing things here right after I left the studio. And when I was here, I had such a wonderful time. And in fact, the last thing I did here was Houston Grand Opera's production of The Marriage of Figaro, where I played the role of the Countess. So I'm so excited for these people here today who are going to have that same opportunity. But you know, We have a lot more opportunities going on here at Houston Grand Opera. We are doing Verterre by Massenet, and that will be one of our new shows that are coming up, and they had a fantastic opening this weekend. It is starring Matthew Polanzani, Isabel Leonard, Sean Paul, and Miss Jasmine Hambersham. Now, we're going to be doing a lot of things this year, and one of them will be outside of the Wortham Theater as well. We'll be doing Giving Voice, which will be at the, I'm sorry, just one moment. Can we please go back? Thank you. Much more, sorry. We're doing live TV, here we go. Our teleprompter went a little crazy. If we can go all the way back down, please, thank you. Perfect, thank you, here we go. And the world premiere we have coming up is Another City, a newly commissioned work for our Song of Houston series. And back here at the Wortham, we will be presenting Zalome and Tosca this spring. There are a lot of opportunities out there in Wortham, as well as the greater Houston community, so that we can have you join us at one or maybe all of those events. Now, this year's Concert of Arias competition. It began last fall with over 945 talented young opera singers from all over the world who applied for their chance to sing here tonight. 14 finalists were selected to come to Houston last week for 2 days of auditions, after which 8 finalists moved on to several days of intense work with the HGO artistic staff. These finalists performed at the evening's competition where they're going to be receiving audience cheers, adoration, and cash prizes. But more importantly, they could be asked to join the prestigious HGO studio next season, like I was. For this competition, each of our finalists will be singing 2 arias accompanied by the music director of HGO studio, Dr. Maureen Zoltek. After everyone has sang their arias, you will get a chance to vote for your favorite performer. The finalist who has the most votes will win the Online Viewer Choice Award. And we'll share the voting instructions on our screen when it is time to vote. Voting does not begin until all the performers have sang twice. While you are voting, the judges will be making their decisions too, which we all know won't be an easy task. The judging panel tonight includes HGO's General Director and CEO, Corey Dastor, Artistic and Music Director, Patrick Summers, and our guest judge, the Grammy Award-winning mezzo-soprano, Isabel Leonard. HGO Artistic Advisor and soprano Anna Maria Martinez will select the Encouragement Award, an award she created to celebrate artists developing their craft. Now, back to Isabel Leonard. She has graced the stages of Vienna, Paris, San Francisco, Carnegie Hall, and the Glyndebourne Festival, and performs regularly at the Metropolitan Opera. Isabel is making her HGO debut as Charlotte in Verterre right now, which had a phenomenal opening last week, and we're so delighted to have her here in Houston. Hello, Isabel.
Hi.
Now, this is your first time in Houston, so I want to know, how has the city been treating you?
Well, first of all, it's fantastic to finally be here in Houston. It has been a long time coming, and it has been great. The weather's lovely. The company is fantastic. Yes. The company is fantastic as well. And it's just a pleasure. It's really a pleasure.
Wonderful. You've sung the role of Charlotte a few times at the Metropolitan Opera House and the Royal Opera House. How does it feel to revisit this role of Charlotte?
Honestly, Charlotte is one of my favorite roles. Mm. It is truly, I think Massenet wrote a brilliant piece from start to finish. She has such an interesting arc. The story is tragic and cathartic and all of these wonderful things. And it is a pleasure. And it is one of those roles that I hope to sing for many years to come.
Wonderful, wonderful. Now, you're on the judging panel tonight. You have a lot of pressure on you. Do you have any advice for these young singers out there?
You know, these competitions are always tricky, I think, because you want to do so, so well, and you're trying to make people like you, I think. Yeah. Right? And I think we spend most of our careers trying to make people like us. And at some point, you have to find the balance between liking yourself, finding the joy in your own performance, and being able to sort of let go in the moment.
Right.
And allowing who you are to shine through, regardless of what anybody else thinks.
There you go.
And that's really hard to do as a young person, so I wish them all so much luck.
I completely agree. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for chatting with me. You have some tough decisions to make, and I do not envy you, so go on ahead and have fun.
Goodbye.
Bye. While the judges are deliberating, you will be casting your vote, and I will be joined here by some special guests during the intermission, after which we'll announce the Concert of Aria winners, and we have a very special Houston Grand Opera announcement from General Director Corey Dastor. So make sure you stay for the full program. In fact, here's Corey.
Hey, Diva.
Hello.
I love this.
Thank you.
Gorgeous.
You too.
Gorgeous,
as always.
Thank you. Yeah. Hi, everyone.
Concert of Arias is one of our most special evenings, and this is your second one here. What are you looking most forward to?
Oh, this is one of our favorite nights of the year, Nicole, because we get to hear the future. We get to hear they're babies, but they're not, and they're ready in this moment to step into the light and show us who they really are, and I'm so excited. I can't wait to be inspired by their artistry this evening.
Me as well. I love this night. So, what can you tell us about that special announcement?
I'm not saying a word.
Oh, okay. So that means you have to hold on and stay the whole time then. Thank you for chatting with me.
I better get out there.
Yes,
bye.
The show has to start. Oh, my goodness. So they're going to the stage, so I will see you in a little moment. I want to invite all of you at home to please join the conversation on HGO social media pages. Our accounts are listed below on the screen. If you're enjoying the show, let us know through comments, likes, shares. Tonight is such a special moment for these young singers, and I'm thrilled to share it with you. The show is about to begin, so I need to take my seat, but I'll see you back at intermission. Enjoy Concert of Arias.
Congrats, girl. And I was like, so then this is hilarious. And
Grand Opera, I'd like to offer you a very warm welcome. In case of an emergency, please locate the exit nearest your seat and follow the instructions of the ushers who will guide you out of the auditorium. Thank you very much for joining us tonight.
Good evening, good evening. And welcome to the 35th annual Eleanor McCollum Competition for Young Singers, also known as the Concert of Arias. I'm Cori Dostour, Houston Grand Opera's General Director and CEO. For 45 years, HGO has been identifying, training, and preparing brilliant emerging artists for significant international careers. Careers that have altered the trajectory of opera itself. This evening, you will witness a thrilling competition, but that's not all. Lives will be changed tonight as these exceptional young singers, selected from around the globe, compete for top honors and the opportunity to join the prestigious HGO Studio program. Their journey starts tonight. I'd like to acknowledge our generous overachieving chairs for the evening, Glenn Rosenbaum and Rita Leader. These two share a profound love of opera and have been working tirelessly on HGO's behalf for decades. As ambassadors, as cheerleaders, and as attorneys with Vincent and Elkins, the international law firm that has represented HGO for 30 years. Because of their determination and plain old hard work, we have exceeded all expectations for this evening's event, one of the highest earning and best attended Concert of Arias programs in recent history. Please join me in thanking these two extraordinary members of the HGO family. Glenn and Rita, please stand up so we can acknowledge you. Thank you. History will be made tonight, and I don't only mean for our special young artists. At the end of the evening, I will also be making a very special announcement that you won't want to miss. So please remain in your seats until the conclusion of our program. I promise you a night you will never forget. Now, it is my honor to welcome to the podium my tremendous colleague and cherished friend, Maestro Patrick Summers.
Thank you. Welcome and thank you so much, Cori. Good evening to you all. I'm Patrick Summers, HGO's Artistic and Music Director. Concert of Arias is one of the greatest nights of the HGO season for a pretty simple reason. Tonight is where you will hear and we will all discover opera's future. Opera is an art focused on all of the meanings of the word voice. Great singers give vocal and dramatic voice to the deep inner voices of composers, conductors, directors, coaches, voice teachers, diction coaches, and yoga teachers, all help them find the best versions of those voices. Singing is the great beating heart of this huge art of opera, and some of the voices you hear tonight may well be starring around the world within the next decade. The generation who will define the future of opera is about to sing for us. So the opportunity both for them and for us is just thrilling. We welcome all of the finalists who have already shown us so many gifts just to get here tonight, and we wish them all the very best for the competition. Tonight, we welcome multiple Grammy Award winner Isabel Leonard as our guest judge. Isabel is currently making her much-anticipated Houston Grand Opera debut, performing as Charlotte in Werther. Please join me in welcoming the wonderful Isabel Leonard. We We are also thrilled to have our new music director of the Houston Grand Opera Studio as our pianist for the evening. Since joining the company, Maureen Zoltek has already had a huge impact on our studio artists. We will welcome her to the stage in just a few moments. Thank you.
As my fellow judges make their way to their seats, I'd like to offer a few more words of thanks. This competition is named for Eleanor Searle McCollum, whose generous early support made tonight possible. We also offer our thanks to our colleagues at Decamera for the loan of their beautiful Steinway D this evening, and would like to acknowledge our event partners, Jackson & Company, the events company, and awards presenter, Houston Methodist, the official healthcare provider of HGO. A huge thank you to the one and only Nicole Houston, serving as our online host for this evening as we stream live to audiences around the world through HGO Digital and our Facebook and YouTube channels. Whether you're watching at home or here with us in the theater, we hope you'll vote for your favorite artist when the time comes. Lastly, please take this moment to silence your cell phones. And now, without further ado, bring on the arias.
I'm Ani Kushian, mezzo-soprano from Georgia. I was born in Georgia in Armenian family, and music has always been an integral part of Armenian household. And I started singing when I was very, very young. My father was priest in Armenian church in Georgia, Tbilisi, and I was singing there 8 years. There are a lot of musicians and artists who inspire me every day. But the biggest inspiration for me is faith in my dream and my goals. And I'm sure that they will come true. Houston has become one of the important cities for me, also for personal reasons. And I feel that my happiness is about to start here. There are a lot of roles, dream roles, that I want to perform in future. And I like powerful woman roles, powerful mezzo roles. I'm feeling good. I'm so excited to be here and can't wait to sing. Tonight I am so excited to begin with the aria of Charlotte from Werther.
My name is Gosh Sarksyan. My voice type is bass, and my hometown is Yerevan, Armenia. It all started from hearing Armenian opera Anush for the first time. I was amazed by the beauty of the music written by Armen Tigranyan and the emotions that it gave to me. And sure, I always liked to sing, but when I first met my teacher, world-famous tenor Geram Grigorian, and have an opportunity to sing for him, he asked me this question: do you really want to become an opera singer? And my answer was definitely yes. And that drove the road for me to become a professional musician. And if I'm here right now, that is definitely the right way to go. Houston Grand Opera feels like a factory of emotions. Factory because of all the hard work done in the backstage to create the emotions in the heart of an opera lover. And Opera Werther that I saw here is a great example of that. My dream role is King Philip II from Verdi's Don Carlo. Right now I'm just a little bit young for that, I know, but I know for sure the day will come. I'm so excited to be here and to meet all the beautiful and young singers from the world, because it means that opera's future is definitely bright. Tonight I'm going to perform Banquo's aria from Verdi's Macbeth opera.
Studia il passo, mio figlio, usciam da queste tenebre. Un senso ignoto nascer mi sento in me. Precipita l'ombra
più sempre a scuola. In note qual trafisserò
My name is Gabrielle Turgeon. I'm a soprano, and I'm currently living in Cincinnati, Ohio. I found my way into opera. First, I was a violinist for my childhood. That was my first instrument, but it never really felt like my thing, really. Putting on Phantom of the Opera, if you can believe that. And I said, you know what, I want to be in that show. I want to sing the lead role. And my mom said, you're going to need some voice lessons if you want to do that. So I started taking voice lessons. And right from the very start, I realized this was my thing. This was my instrument. I haven't looked back since. I love Houston Grand Opera. I first came here last spring for the Young Artists Vocal Academy, and I was just really amazed by the warmth and generosity of all the people here. So I'm so happy to be back for the competition and the Concert of Arias. My dream role would probably be Mimi in La Bohème. I just love that music, and I really hope to sing that one day. I'm feeling really proud of myself and really encouraged to get the validation of making it to this stage of the competition with all the work that I've put in to this point. And I'm really excited to share my voice with everybody. Tonight I will be singing Pace Germani Addio from Idomeneo by Mozart.
Thank you. My name is Samuel Kidd. I'm a baritone, and I'm from Ann Arbor, Michigan, which is right here on the menu. I am an opera nerd. I grew up, my mom was an opera singer, and if you need any more proof of my indoctrination, it's that my parents have 5 cats, all of whom are named after opera characters. So the names are Votan, Sarastro, Dr. Bartolo, Rigoletto, and Jean Valjean, which musical theater, but we still love him. I first came to Houston in 2016 for the Young Artists Vocal Academy, and then and now I was really impressed by the top level of vocal talent on the stage. Seeing shows then, seeing shows now, I was inspired by that, and I strive for that and have been since then. It was really my first sort of foray into the professional opera world. I was a sophomore in undergrad. I knew literally nothing about the industry, and so I came in here and I was just, whoo, eyes open. So it was a really sort of life-changing experience. This one is a little cliche because everyone's favorite opera is La Boheme, but my dream role is Marcello from La Boheme. It was the first opera I was in. I was actually in the children's chorus. I was the little kid that said, I want a trumpet to Parpignol. And my mom sang Musetta many times. And so it's just an opera that has a lot of personal meaning for me. And Marcello's duets with Mimi and with Rudolfo are just spectacular. I'll be starting with Onegin's first act aria, Когда бежит домашним кругом, from Tchaikovsky's Eugene Onegin.
Писали, я трайтесь, я прочел души доверчивое признание, любви невинное излияние. Мне ваша искренность мила, она войне не привела давно. Но все чувства, но вас хвалить я не хочу. Я за нее вам отплачу признанием также без искусства. Примите же исповедь мою, себя на суд вам отдаю. Отцом супругам прятни жреби павилье, то верно, кроме вас одной невесты не искал иной. Но я не создан для блаженства, ему чужда душа моя. Напрасны ваши совершенства, их не достоин вовсе я. Поверьте, совесть в том порукой, супружество нам будет мукой. Я сколько не любил бы вас, привыкнув раз люблю тот час. Судите ж вы, какие роди нам заготовит имене. И, может быть, намного дней. Не
Hi, my name is Natalie Lewis. I'm a mezzo-soprano, and I'm from a military family, so I'm not necessarily from anywhere, but I've lived in California, Maryland, and Massachusetts. I attended two elementary schools, one middle school, two high schools, and at all of these places, the music and performing arts community was always where I found my home, and those are the friends that I still have today. They always welcomed me with open arms, and it always felt like I had been there the whole time. My dream roles are Santuzza from Cavalleria Rusticana and the mezzo soloist in the Verdi Requiem. Santuzza is my dream role because I love the story, and I love how dramatic it is, and I love how real it is. The music is just so beautiful and compelling, and I want to sing it very badly. And then the mezzo soloist in the Verdi Requiem, I would love to sing that also because of the music. I think the mezzo is the star of the Verdi Requiem. I'm feeling excited, which is crazy because oftentimes I'm a mess at times like these, but I'm feeling very excited to sing, and it's just being here is so good. Being here is so fulfilling to me, and I don't think I can feel anything except excited. Tonight, I will be singing Give Him This Orchid from Benjamin Britten's The Rape of Lucretia.
The chaste. My name is Michael McDermott, and I'm a tenor originally from Orange County, California. I started in rock and roll with like Led Zeppelin and the classics, and hated classical music with a passion as I was a little, you know, grungy, revolting teenager. And I just loved to sing. That was like my favorite thing. I was in several rock bands and sang and participated in those. And I still remember freshman year, we had like this sort of arts rotation, and I just tried choir, and I was just so in love with singing. And through that, I just fell in love with the repertoire and collaborating. And at some point, the choral teacher, who's my favorite person in high school, Megan Eddy, I wouldn't be here without her, she told me I should consider getting voice lessons. And so that's kind of how I found my way in. And as I kept working and kept growing, I just fell more and more and more in love with this art form. I think my impression of Houston Grand Opera is a place that collaborates, truly. I think that's what sets it apart. The spirit here is so warm and welcoming, and I found that to be the case in everything that this place does, including the audience. Like, I just went to Voltaire, and the audience reaction is just incredible. And I just want to be part of somewhere that has that much care and that much teamwork, I think. The first aria I will be singing tonight is Se il tuo duol from Mozart's Idomeneo.
Oh! Sarà il duole pronto a fuggir, sarà il duole pronto a fuggir. Se il tuo duole sei il mio desio, se volasse no del pari, obbedirti qual saria, sarà il duole pronto a fuggir, sarà il duole pronto a fuggir, sarà il duole pronto a fuggir.
My name is Emma Marhefka, and I am a soprano from Allentown, Pennsylvania. I started out doing musical theater. I did a ton in middle school and high school, and then I was getting serious about it, and my mom thought, okay, well, maybe we'll take you to do some voice lessons. And so my first teacher was a retired opera singer, and she taught classical technique, which was a totally new world for me. And I just remember as I was studying that technique and started to sing art songs and arias, I just felt so at home in that repertoire, and I just really loved it. And there's something about opera music that just touched me in a way that nothing else has, and so ever since I've just totally been stuck on it. We got to jump right in and see two operas this weekend, which was just so exciting. Not only the incredible talent on the stage that we got to witness, but I found it so exciting to be in the audience, which was so full, and everyone was so invested, you know, laughing along or gasping at the dramatic parts. And I mean, you don't always get that in opera, but I thought it was so cool to see a community that was so invested in the different stories. I would love someday to sing Gilda in Rigoletto. And then, you know, I love new operas, so maybe my dream role is something that hasn't even been written yet. Tonight I will start with Valeria's aria from Mayo by Tom Tupulo.
Who am I? Legally, I am Lord Demetrius Drummond Sampson, Jr., but you can publicize that I am Demetrius Drummond Sampson, Jr. from Albany, Georgia, and I'm a tenor. This may come as a shock to everybody in the universe. They've probably never heard a tenor say that this is their dream role, but my dream role is Rodolfo in La Boheme. So that's the joke. My role model, or someone I look to be like, is my mother. She has struggled her entire life. She raised all three of us, my two siblings and I, for the most part by herself until she was married. And she's always been the strongest woman I've ever met. So my inspiration and my role model is my mother. But when it comes to art, it has to be my chosen family. My three gurus, Aria, Aman, and Colin. That's my chosen family. And for a Black queer person, sometimes the most important people to you can be your chosen family, the people who you choose to walk this path with. Tonight I will be singing Addio Fiorito Azil from Madama Butterfly.
Thank you. son navire.
La folgor tua su me, o se fio alzata contro il mal, alzata contro il mal, contro il mal, alzata contro il mal, contro il mal, contro il mal, alzata contro il mal, contro il mal, contro il mal.
Thank you. Thank you. inizia fine il momento che godrò senza affanno in braccio all'idol mio. Timide cuori, uscite dal mio petto, a turbar non vedete il mio diletto. Come par che all'amoroso fuoco l'amenità del loco, la terra e il ciel risponda.
It's about the way people is made, I reckon, and how they like to believe what's bad, how short they are, love and kindness, it must make the good Lord sad. They don't know it ain't what you feel that counts, but what you do about it. So instead they take it out on you. It must make the good Lord sad. Way out yonder somewheres, the Lord's great heart must break at seeing how men treat one another and say they're doing it all for his sake. It's a hard, hard thing for you to realize, I know, that people won't believe what's bad and how short they are on love and kindness. It must make the good Lord sad.
Arborei never I would leave you. It wouldn't be in summer, seeing you in summer, I never would go. Your hair streaks with sunlight, your lips red as flame, your face with a luster that puts gold to shame. If I'd ever leave you, it couldn't be in autumn. How I'd leave in autumn, I never will know. I've seen how you sparkle when fall nips the air. I know you in autumn, and I must be there. Or could I leave you running merrily through the snow? Or on a wintry evening when you catch the fire's glow? If ever I would leave you, how could it be in springtime, knowing how in spring I'm bewitched by you so? Oh no, not in springtime, summer, winter, or fall. Oh, never could I leave you.
Good evening. My name is Brian Speck, and I am the director of the HGO studio. What an incredible evening. I'm so proud of all of our finalists, and I also want to thank Maureen Zoltek for her beautiful job at the piano. Each of the 8 performers we've seen this evening has a bright future ahead of them. We started this process 6 months ago. After receiving a record 945 applicants, we conducted 251 live auditions and continued to narrow the pool from there. The artists who made it to the Cullen stage tonight are all possessed of remarkable talent. Our finalists have been here in Houston for a whirlwind week of interviews, coaching, and rehearsals with our staff. These young singers have amazed and inspired us with their gifts and their dedication. Working with them has been a wonderful experience for all of us. It's time for a 20-minute intermission. This is your opportunity to vote. Make sure to support your favorite contestant in the Audience Choice and Online Viewer Awards before intermission is over and voting closes. You can find instructions for casting your vote via text on page 13 of your program and up on the screen if you're watching online. Thank you.
Hello again. And if you're just joining us, welcome. I'm Nicole Heaston, your host for HGO's 35th Annual Concert of Arias. Our judges are now deliberating, and it's finally time for you to cast your vote. Each contestant will be assigned a number, which you can now see on your screen. Just text the word online to 833-562-2742. You will then be prompted to cast your vote using a number associated with each artist. Only one vote per person will be accepted. Voting will close in 20 minutes, so make sure you vote now. And while the judges are deliberating, I'm here with last year's winner and current studio artist, Navasard Harkobian. In fact, Navasard and I just performed together in The Marriage of Figaro, where he sang the role of Antonio. Welcome, Navasard.
Hello, Nicole, and good evening, Ernivan, who is watching now the live stream.
Yes. Can you take us back to the moment, like last year about this time? What was it like winning Concert of Arias?
It was a wonderful feeling. I was very happy and excited. This was one of the most memorable moments in my life.
Do you have any advice for these young singers while they're waiting for the results?
Of course, I know they are very stressed waiting for results, but I think being in a final on this competition is already a major victory. I wish them all good luck.
Wonderful. Now, since last year, you have moved to Houston, joined the HGO studio, and made your HGO stage debut. It's been a big year. So can you talk about a highlight that you've had from last year?
Yes, I joined the HGO last year. It was very challenging for me to start a new life in USA. But I am sure I am on a right path. I had many opportunities here to perform with many talented artists and grow as a musician and singer. Mm-hmm. And I'm very thankful to everyone who helped me.
Oh, that's so wonderful. It's so great to hear about your experiences that you've had in your first year in the studio. Thank you, Navasard, for speaking with us.
Thank you.
But we have a short clip here of the two of us together in The Marriage of Figaro. We'll watch a few moments from the finale of Act Two with me as the Countess and Navasard as Antonio.
Peggio, e poc'anzi bodarsi di peggio, fidi nuovi, signor mio, di dar giò.
Guarda pure!
Vedete i garaffali
in giardino!
Sì, cosa
sento?
Su e cisco cerco,
camminato che viene a far qui.
Dunque un buon manovetto dove cito.
Rato rato il birbone fuggito, e ad un tratto di vista uscì.
So tutto lo vidi.
Cherubin!
Avete detto?
A questo punto,
suo punto da Siviglia cavallo qui giunto da Siviglia dove forse sarà
questo no che il cavallo io non vidi saltare di là
che pazienza
come mai
finiamo questo ballo
che finirà
dunque tu salta giù ah perché il timor che timor l'ha rinchiuso aspettando quel caro visetto ti petà più sussurro fortuso poi gridaste lo scritto biglietto salta in giù dal terrore confuso e stravolto un nervo del piede
vostre dunque saranno queste carte che
ora portile a me sono in trappola sono in trappola
figaro all'erba figaro all'erba
dite un po' questo foglio cos'è tosto tosto ne ho tanti aspettate
sarà forse il sommario dei debiti
la lista degli osti parlate e tu lascialo
lasciami
che parli
parto sì ma se torna troppo lascialo
vanne non temo di te
lascialo
parto sì ma se torna troppo lascialo
e
if you haven't cast your vote for tonight's online Viewer's Choice winner, there is still time. Text online to 833-562-2742 and follow the instructions in the messages. And now I am joined by two of the stars of HGO's current production of Werther, Sean Michael Plum, who is singing the role of Albert, and Jasmine Hammershin, who is singing Sophie. Welcome, Jasmine and Sean. Hi, guys.
Hi, how are you doing tonight?
You know, this is a unique opportunity for our Houston audiences to see this beautiful opera that has not been performed at HGO since the 1970s. It is also, both of you all, your debut here at HGO, and we're so thrilled that you all are here. And can you give me a little bit of insight on what this experience has been like for you?
Yeah, I think for me, the experience has been kind of definitely elevated. It's a wonderful company to be at, and also it's wonderful to perform with Sean again. We were both young artists at Glimmerglass together, so we actually did a performance of Papageno and Papagena, so it's really full circle, and I've had such a wonderful time being here.
That is so great. Now, Jasmine, this is your role debut of Sophie. Can you tell me what it's like learning the role of Sophie and performing it here?
Yes, so as I was learning the role, of course, you know, trying to get the French down was the hardest part for me. And I still have to continue to do that. But the way that the role is written, it's so much fun. And she is like the light of the story.
Yeah.
Because it's very depressing. however, I really love like the cheerfulness that Massenet like puts in her lines and all of the like the coloratura, you know, when she's trying to cheer up Charlotte. And so I've had such a great time singing it. So it's really been a pleasure.
That is so wonderful. Now, the Werther cast includes current HGO studio artists. Can you talk about the special bond that you have with them when they're for the first time doing such a special production like this?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, rightfully, everyone is so excited about Matthew and Isabel, and they are singing these roles at the highest possible level and inspiring
wonderful.
Everyone in the room. But on the first day of rehearsal, we all listened to the HGO studio artists. Everyone's head turned. Couldn't believe it. The voices are incredible. How professional and ready they already are. Being able to talk to them about shared experiences, about going through the process only a few years ago has been wonderful, and watching them on stage has honestly been inspiring.
Oh, that's wonderful. Now, I'm going to give a big toy for the remaining three performances. Make sure you get your tickets if you have not seen it yet. Let's give everyone a short preview, though. This is an excerpt from Act One featuring Sean Michaels Plum and Jasmine Habersham.
Sophie,
I got
a toy. We know.
Time is ticking for you to get your vote in for Online Viewer's Choice. It's simple. Just text the word online to 833-562-2742. The prompts will tell you how to vote. Only one vote per person will be accepted. I want to tell you about our next project. On February 24th, HGO is presenting the 4th annual Giving Voice Concert. This event was created by tenor Lawrence Brownlee, who in his words felt it was important that the diversity regularly seen on HGO stage be reflected in the audience. So he created Giving Voice to welcome Black and African American community members into HGO and to this art form. KHOU news anchor Lynn Cannon will be hosting this event, and the soloists will include Lawrence Brownlee, myself, as well as studio artists Renee Richardson and Corey McGee. And we are honored to have the legendary tenor George Shirley, who will be performing at this concert with us. Mr. Shirley was the first African-American tenor to perform a leading role at the Metropolitan Opera. Also, for the first time, this concert will not be at the Wortham Theater, but at Wheeler Avenue Baptist Church. And we're adding a choral element for the first time. The HGO chorus will be joined by choirs from Wheeler Avenue Baptist Church, Houston Ebony Opera Guild, Prairie View A&M University, and Texas Southern University. The combined choirs will perform three numbers, including one by HGO's composer in residence, Joelle Thompson. I'm delighted to be now in, I'm being joined by, oh my gosh, they came and shocked me. Renee and Corey, welcome you two.
Thank you.
Hello.
You guys look beautiful.
You look beautiful as well. Thank you.
Corey, you and I have sung Giving Voice before. Can you tell the audience a little bit about what they're going to experience in the concert and what the audience can expect?
Yes, so my first year in the HGO studio was part of the HGO digital season. So we didn't have a live audience, but I got the chance to sing Mozart's Concert Aria Così Dunque Tradisci. And then we all sang, I think it was The Whole World, This Little Light of Mine.
Yes.
That's what we all sang. Oh, it was so beautiful. But I think this year the audience will have a chance to revel in the talent on stage of probably 200 plus people. Just enjoy a night of celebrating our people.
Yes. Now, as studio artists, you get to have a mix of opera productions as well as concerts like this. Tell me what it's like to have that type of mix of performances versus the style of repertoire you do in the studio.
Well, me personally, I have such a passion for spiritual, so I'm very excited that I'll be able to sing my favorite spiritual on this concert. I'm not going to tell you what it is, because I want it to be a surprise.
Okay.
But it's wonderful because I get to have this opera exposure and get to learn and grow, but then also go back to my roots and sing spiritual, so I'm very excited about that.
I'm excited, too. I don't even know what you're singing, but I'm going to find out. So this year, we'll have a lot of new exciting elements. Can you tell us about what you're most excited for in this year's concert?
Me personally, George Shirley.
Yes.
I just worked with him in Detroit. He was the wanderer in the Backwards Bohème, and I sang Colline. Wow. And so we got to be on stage together, and he was just so supportive of all of the artists on stage, but he never failed to just grab you by the wrist and be like, and that was just so beautiful backstage. Aww. And just always, just every single time I could, and he still warmed up to a high B in his dressing
room.
Yes. I was like, oh my gosh, it was truly wild, truly wild. But
hey.
How about you?
Well, I mean, I'll piggyback off of that. I'm very excited to see George Shirley. He's such an inspiration, but Larry Brownlee, who I've loved for several years, one of my favorite tenors, of course, Nicole Heeson, I've gotten to study under you in Le Nozze di Figaro, but I'm really excited for the collaboration. As you mentioned, there's so many different choirs that are going to be joining us. So I'm excited just to have such a big group of people on stage, and it's just going to be amazing. I've watched Giving Voice for the past 2 years, so it's exciting to finally be a part of something like that. So it definitely makes me feel good, especially during Black History Month, for sure.
It's going to be epic, I can tell you that.
Sure.
Now, I want to thank you both for sharing this information about the upcoming Giving Voice concert and the experiences that you've had. Now, tickets are free, so head to HGO's website and reserve your spot. And you know what? We might as well look back at an earlier Giving Voice concert with me and Lawrence Brownlee singing an excerpt from L'Elisir d'Amore.
La 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 finora amor non sente. La 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 la.
Vuol farli indifferente,
finora amor non sente.
Vuol farli indifferente,
finora amor non sente. Esulti pur la Barbara, per poco le mie pene. Domani avranno termine, domani m'amena la perfida, domani m'amena, sì m'amena.
Hey!
hearing that the votes are coming in and the race is tight. So make sure you get your vote in for Online Viewer's Choice. For their award, all you have to do is text online to 833-562-2742, and the instructions will tell you what to do. There are only a few minutes left. I am delighted to introduce everyone to HGO's two studio pianists and coaches, Binyu Sanford and Michelle Pappenfuss. Welcome.
Hello.
Hello.
Can you talk us through the work of an HGO studio pianist and coach? What's a normal day like?
So we coach studio artists and we work together with them. And then when there is a main stage rehearsal production, then we play the rehearsals.
Yeah.
And we do get piano lessons.
We also play for their voice lessons, movement classes, I don't know, anything that the studio artists need. Yeah, we also have language classes, so they keep us pretty busy, and it's pretty varied every day.
Awesome. Now, what do you enjoy most about preparing an opera for HGO?
I mean, there are so many wonderful things. It's hard to pick one. But for me, it's working with studio artists. Because, you know, it's not just me studying the score, but we witness from the very beginning that they are preparing their role, and it's always inspiring for me to see them shine on the stage.
Aww.
For me, to add to that, it's also been really amazing to work with so many amazing music staff members and then guest artists like you. I'm so humbled that I got to work on Figaro with you.
Thank you. You played lovely.
Thank you. but just seeing the amazing musicians, and I feel like I'm constantly inspired to be better as a musician myself by all the people that we're surrounded with.
Nice. Now, what is your dream opera that you would like to work on, and why?
I mean, it's a hard question because it's hard to pick just one.
Yeah.
But for me, my dream opera is Rosenkavalier.
Ah.
I mean, of course, the vocal line is just amazing, and just the drama is so lovely and comic. But the orchestration is so exuberant. It's like there is almost, you feel like there's no bar line. It's a continuous conversation between vocal line, and I just love it, yeah.
So my favorite opera is Peter Grimes by Benjamin Britten. For lots of reasons, I think it's compelling both musically and dramatically. And I think the story is just, I don't know, it's a really important story that should be told throughout the ages. And I think it can be viewed through a lot of lenses. And personally, I will always remember the first time I heard the 4C interludes from that opera. I just, you know, fell in love with Britten's music. So it would be a privilege to get to work on that.
Those are both good choices. Thank you both for sharing your work and your artistry with us, because without you, we couldn't do what we do. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, everyone, this is your last chance to vote. All you have to do is text online to 833-562-2742. Follow the instructions and your count will be voted. Or your vote will be counted. Live, you know? I am delighted to now be joined by studio artists Emily Treagle and Meryl Dominguez. Welcome, Emily and Meryl.
Hello.
Certainly. Now, you are both former contestants in the Concert of Arias. Do you remember the day and remember the feeling when you were asked to join the studio?
Very, very well. So if anybody tuned into my Concert of Arias year, it was 2021. I was on wheels. I was on an e-scooter, so I had to learn how to sing on one foot. But yes, I remember it very, very well. It was an amazing, amazing day. I really feel like I had to sort of defy all odds, but it was so fun. It was also a COVID year, so there was no one actually in the audience. It was just a bunch of cardboard cutouts of people, which was also very strange. So definitely not something I would forget. But when I found out I was in the studio, I was actually hanging out with my best friend, Corey McGee, who y'all heard from a little bit earlier, and I was in his apartment, and I just like wept like such a baby. Aww. This was my dream forever and still is, so I'm so, so happy to be here.
Yeah, I mean, competitions are always very stressful, right? But I find that like once you get to the finals, you can just enjoy it and you can just like relish in it. And I hope that like everyone tonight got to actually enjoy the performance and they weren't like terrified the entire time. I think they did. They sounded wonderful. And
they did.
They all looked so at home on the stage. So it was a bit of a blur for me, the Concert of Arias week, I guess. But when I got the invitation to join the studio, I was at home, and my husband and I were trying to figure out where we were going to live the next year. And so we were like looking at apartments, and then I got a call, and I was like, we're going to live in Houston, actually.
There you go.
Kind of surprised, and it was a wonderful surprise. So
that is so awesome. Now, you both are performing in a special HGO production. It's a world premiere entitled Another City. And this music is done by Jeremy Howard Beck and libretto by Stephanie Fleischman. Can you tell us a little bit about the piece and what it's like to do a world premiere?
Yeah, absolutely. So Another City follows multiple characters through their stories and in various parts of experiencing homelessness. So there are people that work as part of the social work structure in Houston, and it's all based in Houston as well. And then there are people who are in shelters. There are people who recently got housing. Houston has actually one of the more innovative programs for dealing with homelessness. They give housing before you have a job, which is very rare. And I've been learning a lot about the program in Houston since working on this opera. It's very interesting. The music is wonderful. The libretto is so touching, so moving. There are even some transcripts of just actual interviews that they had with people in Houston who are experiencing this. So it should be a very, very moving event.
And this was definitely my first new work that I've worked on. Mm-hmm. And y'all, it's definitely different than learning like Verdi or Mozart. It's definitely like a very sort of collaborative project with the coaches that you're working on it with, and then eventually when the composer gets here and the conductor, like figuring it all out. But it's challenging, but it's really exciting.
It's always great to learn a new musical language.
Yeah.
You know, so I think that you all are getting great experience with that, because the future is new contemporary opera.
Absolutely.
So what is your favorite part of being a part of the Houston Opera Studio?
For me, mm-hmm. I'd say that I think it's the people. I know that all the contestants kept echoing the sentiment that it's really warm around here. And that's true, I think, within the like rehearsals for the main stage productions. All of the people that are hired for each of the productions are always so nice. And you can never tell who's in the studio versus who's a hired artist. Everybody is treated exactly the same.
Yes.
But also, just like the energy amongst the studio artists, you would think that because this is like, you know, a super high-level young artist program, that it might be more cutthroat or super competitive. And literally, like, we would all take bullets for each other.
Absolutely.
We, like, are so, so supportive of each other. And, like, no one has a bad thing to say about any of us. So, I don't know. It's just a very warm family environment.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the people are amazing. But it's also, like, an amazing part of being in the studio is you get to be in the room where it happens. Like,
yeah.
not to quote Hamilton.
Where it happens.
But, like,
where it happens.
Exactly.
Where it happens. Sorry.
Apparently, we're just going to do Hamilton now.
Right.
But yeah, I mean, there's so many amazing guest artists, yourself, you know, and Matthew and Isabel and everybody in Verter and everyone in Noce. Just like being able to experience and see how you work is one of the best educational things that any of us could get.
1,000%.
Yeah.
Awesome. I keep saying that because everything is awesome. My goodness. So now let's look at an excerpt from Act 2 of HGO's production of La Traviata this fall. This features Emily singing the role of Flora and Kelly Markgraf singing the Marquis with the HGO chorus.
Thank you.
I've just received word that our judges have finally made their decisions. It's time to go back to the stage for the live announcement of tonight's winners. I can't wait to see the results. It's going to be fabulous. And I'll be back with you at the end of the program, so let's go to the stage.
Welcome back. I'm Maureen Zoltek, the music director of the HGO studio. I can assure you, thank you. I can assure you our judges have not had an easy time selecting tonight's winners. Thanks to everyone who voted, we'll be sharing these results shortly. And now, a celebratory selection from Puccini's La Rondine, featuring our current studio artists. Cheers.
Già che il caso ci unisce, inneggiamo all'amore. Inneggiamo alla vita che ci sono l'amore. Devo al tuo fresco sorriso, devo al tuo sguardo profondo.
Before we announce our winners, a quick reminder to stay afterward for a big announcement about HGO's future from Corey Dastor. This is exciting, breaking news, and we want you to share in this historic moment with us, so stay put. We want to thank all of our finalists for sharing their gifts with us this evening and recognize the tremendous preparation they've put into making this an unforgettable night. Thank you.
The presenting sponsor of tonight's awards is Houston Methodist, the official healthcare provider for Houston Grand Opera. The Houston Methodist Center for Performing Arts Medicine is the leading provider of specialized artist healthcare, integration of the arts into the hospital and clinical patient care, and research that seeks to harness the broadest potential of the arts in therapy and rehabilitation. Presenting the awards is Dr. Mas Takashima, the chairman of Houston Methodist's ENT practice. HGO is proud to welcome Dr. Takashima to the stage, along with our esteemed judges, Corey Dastor, Isabel Leonard, and Patrick Summers.
The Ana Maria Martinez Encouragement Award was established to provide critical financial support for lessons, coachings, auditions, and the many other expenses that singers encounter while pursuing a professional career. Named for and selected by renowned soprano, HGO Studio graduate, and current HGO Artistic Advisor, Ana Maria Martinez, this prize is awarded each year to one special singer. As Ana Maria is performing in Los Angeles this evening, she has been tuning in online, and she has made her selection. The honor falls to me to announce that tonight, the Ana Maria Martinez Encouragement Award winner is Gabrielle Turgeon.
Thank you to all those of you who followed tonight's competition online. The online Viewer's Choice Award winner is Natalie Lewis.
Thank you all for participating in the vote for our Audience Choice winner. The winner is Demetrius Sampson Jr.
The third prize in the 2023 Eleanor McCollum competition goes to Michael McDermott.
Second prize goes to Demetrius Sampson Jr.
First prize in the 35th Eleanor McCollum competition for young singers is a check for $10,000. The winner of the Scott F. Hoyman Memorial Prize is Natalie Lewis. Please join us in one more round of applause for all of our finalists, and we welcome to the stage our current studio members to join us in this moment.
Hi, I'm Tamara Wilson. HGO audiences may know me as Turandot or Leonora. This spring, I'll be performing in Houston as Tosca. My career in opera started in 2005 when I won the first prize at the Concert of Arias. That moment changed my entire life, and I am not alone. Here are some other opera stars, all competition winners and former studio members, on what the experience has meant to them.
I think the HGO studio has always been one of the most prestigious young artist program, even in the whole world, actually.
It was the very first thing that I did once I left college, and I was kind of shocked at the amount of knowledge and support that I was going to get from this company. So it started everything. If I had not been here, I don't know where my career would be.
Being able to have the coachings, the lessons, the working with directors and conductors in productions, not just as a cover, not just sitting in the room.
I think it feels like a surreal experience. I just feel so incredibly lucky to be around the best mentors, the best colleagues, and be learning from them.
The HGO studio is a very tight-knit group that you're with for 2 to 3 years, and you develop these relationships and trust and the people in the company, and you gain confidence through them, and it helps you just become a better person and better artist.
The biggest takeaway of being in the HGO studio is the real world experience that you get. And it's an incredibly supportive environment, though. We're not just thrown out in there to the sharks, you know, in a rehearsal room.
Being a young artist, When a big company trusts you and puts you into a main stage show, that already means a lot. That means the trust from the management team, and it means that it's a encouragement for us to be better and to chase the goal even harder.
We are people who are brought out to the audience of Houston as young singers, and they nurture that so that the audience gets to know us even as we age and as we change into different roles and do things. They make us part of the Houston community, and that is what makes this so great.
And now, HGO's General Director and CEO, Corey Dustor, has some incredible news to share about the future of the HGO studio.
As the brilliant Tammy Wilson has promised, it is my great pleasure to share this extraordinary news. Every donation to the arts is important, but major gifts, like the one I'm about to announce, are rare and transformative. They give us an opportunity to dream bigger, to go further into our vision, to celebrate the past with a hopeful future. For what is so often a narrative of decline in the arts, moments like this prove to us that the arts are as vital and as hopeful as what we heard on the stage tonight. For more than 35 years, Ernest and Sarah Butler have made the drive from Austin and back for the Sunday matinee of every production in the HGO season. They're watching tonight via live stream from out of the country. Tonight, this visionary couple are making the largest contribution in Houston Grand Opera's history, creating a fund within the HGO endowment valued at $22 million. So, from this moment forward, the HGO studio will be the Sarah and Ernest Butler Houston Grand Opera Studio. Join me in applause to celebrate the Butler's incredible generosity. Thank you, Sarah and Ernest, watching from the Dominican Republic. We love you. On behalf of HGO's board and staff, a huge thank you to our event chairs, Len Rosenbaum and Rita Leader, our esteemed guest judge, Isabel Leonard, all of this evening's talented performers, and to you, our audience, for joining us tonight. If you're celebrating with us at dinner, please head out to the Grand Foyer. Thank you, everyone, and good night.
This has been at Houston Grand Opera's 35th Concert of Arias competition. I've had a blast, and I hope you did too. If you would like to learn more about the HGO studio, upcoming performances, community programming, or how you can just support the opera, please visit hgo.org. I want to thank you for joining us, and good night.
Uccell, verso, verso.